Federal Labor has seized on court documents to accuse Tony Abbott of having advance knowledge of sexual harassment claims against the Speaker. TEN's National Affairs editor Paul Bongiorno's in Canberra. Paul, this story, well, what twists and turns?
Well, Sandra, I can say there's an irony here. The transcripts of text messages to and from James Ashby, the accuser of Peter Slipper, were meant to support his case. Instead, they've turned out to be a treasure trove for Peter Slipper and for the government. Peter Slipper caught on the hop in America when a flood of accusations were filed in an Australian court, and the opposition immediately went on the attack.
To require the Speaker to step down.
2 months later, Mr. Slipper's defence in court documents alleges collusion between his accuser, James Ashby, and senior members of the Liberal National Party.
This was about securing a political advantage for the coalition.
Text messages are cited to show close contact between Mr. Ashby and Mel Brough, the man who wants Mr. Slipper's seat. At first denied and then admitted. Also revealed discussions with LNP Queensland Minister Mark McArdle. His Premier denies criminality, but admits it doesn't look good.
I'm afraid it's the normal sort of machinations in politics, sadly.
Those machinations, according to extensive text messages, go wider than previously admitted. Also in the net, Christopher Pyne, Joe Hockey and Clive Palmer.
Look, all of our contact is on the record. It's absolutely and utterly innocuous.
It is time for the opposition to come clean about everything they know, their involvement in all of this.
Anthony Albanese makes no apology for launching an attack on the opposition, despite the fact the matters are now before the federal court. He says it was Tony Abbott and the opposition who first dragged the affair into the political arena. The government won't be letting go. Mr. Ashby could face a police investigation himself for alleged theft of Mr. Slipper's diary. Now, federal police say they're still investigating allegations that Mr. Slipper abused his travel entitlements, and they're yet to receive any referral into the Ashby matter.
OK, Paul, thank you.